Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel and if you are new here then hi, my name is Shaini and today we are doing nighttime photoshoot at home and also I will be sharing how I edit those pictures in this video. So I got the idea because of the weather. As you know, most of the time I click my pictures in the sunlight directly. I go to terrace and then I click my pictures, but it's so freaking hot here in Kolkata that I cannot do that right now. So one day I was just going through Pinterest and saw some nighttime portraits and I really liked the idea of it. So I thought of, let's do it. So today we are going to do that and also I will be editing those pictures in this video as well. So let's get started with today's video. But before that, if you are new here and haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please consider subscribing to my channel. Also follow me on my Instagram. This is my Instagram handle and this is my Instagram feed. Please go follow me there right now and yeah, now let's get into the video. Okay, so I just changed the top and by the way, for the prop I won't be using anything. It's just going to be me in this picture, just me posing randomly, sitting pose ideas. So yeah, let's click the pictures. Also ignore my voice. For this picture, you need to keep a phone with the torch light on. You can even use a normal torch as the light source. And in front of the light, I'm keeping this glass globe and you can see it's reflecting a beautiful shadow. Now let me switch off the light and show it to you guys that how beautiful it's looking in the dark. Here I'm gonna keep my phone and I'm gonna sit right there, then sit and give some dreamy poses, try giving bold expression which suits the picture theme. Do these things with your hands. I wanted to keep a glass full of water in front of the light. It also create beautiful shadows like this, but I suddenly found this glass globe and used it instead of glass of water. But I know this isn't something that everyone already had at their home, so you can use a glass of water instead or a prism or even some paperweights also. These things also works as the same as a glass globe and yeah, these are the results. I will edit these pictures later, so watch the video till the end to know how I have edited them.
Okay, I just got done getting ready and this is what I'm wearing, this beautiful top, this obviously top. Let's start clicking the pictures.
So for this picture, you need a paper funnel like this. Just roll the paper wide at the top and narrow at the bottom. Now again, you need a phone for this pictures as the light source and stick this funnel's narrow side on the top of the torch just like this. And I am keeping this here. Now as a prop, I am going to use this fake leaves. You can use flowers too. Now just switch off the light and start clicking the pictures. Nothing fancy, just sit and pose something like this with the leaves. Feel the theme of the picture and pose. And yeah, this is how the pictures have turned out. And again, for the editing tutorial, watch the video till the end.
Okay, so for the next picture idea, props ke liye, you don't need anything. This pictures are again going to be very normal, only pose kind of a picture. These pictures will be flashlight, those old vintagey kind of a flashlight wala picture. So I will edit the pictures baad mein, but you need to click these pictures on flashlight. So yeah, let's quickly click these pictures.
So I couldn't record the screen for these pictures because the lights were off. The only light was a flashlight and these are the results.
Okay guys, so I just got done clicking the pictures, but the pictures, I'm not happy with the pictures because first I had no idea what I was doing, so I had to click the pictures very randomly. Main randomly pose kari thi and I continued clicking those pictures, but we have to make them work, make them Instagrammable. So for that I have to edit the pictures because I knew the pictures won't be that great because flashlight wala pictures achhe nahi aate hain. It's currently 10:30. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna like quickly remove this makeup and change this outfit because mujhe bahut garmi lag rahi hai. So I'm gonna quickly do that and I'm gonna start editing the pictures quickly. So I have changed my outfit, also removed my makeup. Now before going ahead with the picture editing, I quickly want to pamper my skin for bedtime so that I can totally sit, relax and edit the picture. So thought of sharing it with you guys too. I hope you won't mind. So the very first thing I'm gonna use is a face wash, which is Mamaearth Upton face wash for tan removal. I have been using this face wash from quite a few months now and I swear I'm totally in love with this face wash and this has to be my favorite face wash till now. So taking a generous amount of the face face wash and gently massaging my wet face with it. It has turmeric and saffron extracts in it, which helps removing tan and gives your skin instant glow. It also has walnut beads in it, so this is just not only works as a face wash but also a scrub too. It deeply cleanses, exfoliates dead skin cells. I love the smell of this face wash, you guys. It smells like pure saffron and upton. I love how the texture of the face wash is so rich, thick and cream based, so it does not leave your skin dry at all. My skin feels so soft, healthy, glowy after washing it off. It obviously does the job it claims. You should definitely give this face wash a try. I am pretty sure you're gonna love this face wash too. After washing my face with the face wash, to complete the skincare, I like to use this Mamaearth Upton Night Face Mask for glowing skin. I have recently came across with this product and I am so much in love with this product already because I am noticing how my skin feels right after using this face mask. Let me show you an interesting and cool thing about this product, which is its texture. I have never seen this kind of texture in my entire life. It looks so, I don't know how to explain it. Let's say it looks like ice. It even feels like ice or watery texture on the skin. It's not gel based, it's not creamy, not oily, not totally transparent, but after applying it, it will feel like that you have applied a matte filter in real life. That's how I would like to explain it. It has turmeric and niacinamide, which is actually vitamin B3, which helps reducing acne, eczema and other inflammatory skin conditions. It keeps your skin smooth and moisturized, so taking little amount of the mask at a time and spreading it evenly in a thin layer all over my face and my neck too. And that's it, keep it for overnight and wash it off in the morning. Now if you're someone who is concerned about how can someone sleep with a mask on their face, it's so uncomfortable and all, it's not, trust me in this. It's so lightweight that you won't even feel like you have applied something on your face. Rather, it's so cooling and hydrating that you feel so much peaceful and relaxed after applying it. And in the morning after washing your face, your skin will definitely be glowing. Just look at my face, looks so healthy and plumpy. So go get your hands on this amazing product. Mamaearth is a plastic positive Indian brand and their products are free from harmful chemicals like silicone and paraben, and they are made of all the natural ingredients. Also, every time you buy from them, they will link your order on their website to a treat that they plant, and they will send you the exact geolocation, the picture and the species of the plant. Use my code, which is POD2021, to get a 20% discount on your order. This is valid only at their website. Mamaearth products are also available on Mamaearth, Amazon, Nykaa and Purple. Mamaearth also has launched their official website. Users get early access to sales and will get extra discounts. So I am done pampering my skin. I just applied the face mask and now let's start with the editing. By the way, I use Redmi Note 8 Pro to click my pictures in case you are interested to know. Also, I don't use any other camera app. I just use the normal selfie camera of my phone to shoot my videos and to click my pictures too. And I use Lightroom to edit all my pictures, and for some pictures I use PicsArt, I use Snapseed and B612 and the app Snow. Before starting with the editing, here is another thing I wanted to clarify, which is I won't be explaining every features, like how the every features of the Lightroom works in this video, because I have already did that in one of my videos. So go watch the editing tutorial part 1. The link is in the description box in case you are new and don't know much about Lightroom. So if you know how the features works, it will be easier for you to understand how to edit your pictures, because every picture does not have the same lighting, same color tones and all. So the editing I will be doing in my picture that might not be suitable for your picture too. So yeah, this video is just for a basic idea to how to edit your pictures. Okay, so let's start. First, going to the light tab to edit the light settings. Won't be changing the exposure because it's already has good exposure. Contrast will also remain zero. Will decrease the highlights a lot, shadows, and also decreasing the white and then increasing the blacks. Then going to the curve tab for advanced light setting, increasing the shadow point up so it creates this faded effect, which I absolutely love. Taking the mid-tones point a little down like this. You have to understand how this curves works. For that, watch my editing tutorial part 1 and then experiment with this curves. And yeah, this is how the final white curves looks like, not doing anything with the red and green curve. Then going to the blue curve and editing the mid-tones a bit, and this is how it looks like. Tab done when you are done, and then going to the color tab and first going to this grading option. I wanted this picture to have a pale bluish color tone. So going to the highlight section and increasing the saturation first so that I can see which highlighting color I exactly want in this picture. Then increasing the hue to the blue color, then increasing the blending, then tap done. When you are done, then I will be increasing the tint to the pinkish side and then increasing the temperature, decreasing the vibrance and increasing the saturation a little. Then going to the color mix tab. Now edit the colors according to your picture colors. I'm increasing the saturation of the red and decreasing the luminance, decreasing the saturation of the orange a little and increasing the luminance for yellow, decreasing the hue and the saturation and increasing the luminance. Won't be editing the other colors because this picture does not have any other colors. Then copying this whole editing and pasting it on the other pictures, and yeah, these are the final results. Edit these pictures, I'm first going to the B612 app and going to this AR filter section and applying this filter, then saving the picture. Did this with all the pictures too, and now I will be editing this picture in Lightroom. So first decreasing the exposure, then increasing the contrast very little, then decreasing the highlights, the shadows and the whites, and lastly increasing the blacks. Then going to the curve section and editing the white curve first. This is how the final white curve looks like. You can take a screenshot of it, then tap done. Going to the color tab, then going to the grading section and changing the hue of the shadows to the greenish side, increasing the saturation very little, then tap done. And after that increasing the tint very little, then increasing the vibrance and decreasing the saturation a little, then going to the color mix option. Now there is nothing to explain here, so here is a screenshot of each and every editing of the colors. You can take screenshot and copy paste this on your pictures. Now going to the effects tab, decreasing the texture and the clarity to make the picture little dreamy, decreasing the dehaze and vignette to make the corner of the picture blackish, increasing the grains, and yeah, that's the final picture. Now copy paste the same, I mean the editing, on your other pictures too. And yeah, for this picture, first going to the light tab, then increasing the exposure, then decreasing the contrast, then decreasing the highlights, then the shadows and whites, and lastly the blacks too. And then going to the curve tab and editing the white curve first. This is how it's gonna look like. And then going to the red curve, editing the midtones a bit, same doing to the green curve, and lastly the blue curve too. And this is how this curve's gonna look like. Take a screenshot and then going to the color tab and then grading section, increasing the saturation of the shadow, then changing the hue little greenish side, then increasing the balance, and then tap done. When you are done, then I will be increasing the tint and the vibrance and decreasing the saturation. Then going to the mix tab, and here are the screenshot of those. Only edited these three colors because there is no other color here in the picture, so you can take a screenshot of this. Then going to the effects tab and increasing the clarity a little bit, decreasing the vignette to bring blackish sides, increasing the grain, and then going to the details tab and increasing the sharpness a little bit. Then going to this profile section and then go to the modern and applying this filter called modern 6 and increase the amount of it. And yeah, here are the final pictures. And yeah, that is all about this video. I hope it was helpful and you enjoyed watching. If so, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you want to watch more such content in future. Also, comment down below, share this video if you liked it. Your comments means a lot to me. You have no idea how it helps to encourage me. So please comment down below anything you want. Follow me on my Instagram. This is my Instagram handle. And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.